Hey Savvy People, it's SavvyNik here, and today I'll continue with episode 6 in the C++ tutorial for beginners. In this episode, we'll be covering the input-output stream and how to interact with the system console. Alright, so as we've seen in a few of the other past episodes, we've included this iostream class from the standard library, and we really haven't talked about what this is or what it means. So IO here just means input output, and using some of the objects inside of this IO stream header will allow us to interact with a user through the console and also to write and read characters to and from the screen. So let's go ahead and use cout as our first example. So we've done this already in the past, and this is actually a object out of the iostream header, and we'll talk about objects in the future, but for now, we'll call cout an object that comes from iostream. So what cout stands for is character output, and what you do with it is output characters to the console. So we've done this in the past where we've done two less than symbols, and then we type something behind here, so like SavvyNik. Quotes just mean that this is a string, that's why I put it around here. And this allows us to print something to the console, so I'm putting an end line. Now I can put as many of these double less thans as I want, and all it does is really just concatenates or puts together the previous portion with the next portion. So all of this gets shoved together and then it displays something. So let's say I wanted to go ahead and put something like was here afterwards, and I can go ahead and use two more less than symbols. Now what I would expect is SavvyNik, a new line, was here, and then another new line. So let's go ahead and compile this, make sure it does run. Let me just return zero here for completion purposes. And let's start a console. All right, and in my console, I went ahead and called this file iostream. So I did iostream.cpp and output that to iostream. If I go ahead and compile the program and then run the iostream program, we'll get SavvyNik, a new line character, was here, another new line character, which just pushes our line here. That's really it for cout. It just allows us to output characters to the console, and developers like to use cout as a tool to display information at certain parts of a program, especially while trying to debug or get a rough draft going. This is an easy way to go ahead and just display some information in the console. It's also great for testing certain scenarios and figuring out what path your program is taking and if that matches your expectations. So another way we could use cout is, let's say we wanted to do some math here, and I'm just gonna make an integer and call it value 1. I'll set it equal to 1, and then I'll do int value 2 and set it equal to 2. I can actually use operations inside cout. So if I did cout and just said value 1 plus value 2, and I'll put an end line here just to make things look a little better. If we compile this and run, we'll be able to see that these two values will get added together, and that will be displayed in the console. So let's give that a shot. I'll go ahead and compile and run the program. And as you can see here, we have a 3 now. Keep up with the series and support the channel by subscribing below and hitting the notification bell for more Linux and programming videos. Well, that's really it for cout. You've seen it in the past, but let's talk about something new. So we talked about how to output characters to the console. Is there a way to get characters from the console? Well, there is. It's something called cin. So this just stands for character input. Now the big difference here, instead of using less than symbols, we use greater than symbols. And I just like to think of it as you're pushing all of this over to the console, and then from the console, you're pushing something into the program. So how can I push something that comes from the program? Well, I could push it into a value if I wanted. So let's say I'm gonna reuse that value 1 and then do cin value 2. And why this is nice is because we have value 1 and value 2 defined above, but what if we wanted to get those values from a user? Well, we can do it this way. So I'm going to erase this initialization of the 2, and then I'm actually going to copy this below so we can display it after we get some information from the user. And then finally, I'll go ahead and ask the user to supply the program with 2 numbers. Please supply 2 numbers. And let's go ahead and run our very first program that can get values from a user using the Cin object. All right, go ahead and compile and run that. And it says, please supply two numbers with the blinking cursor here. I'm going to go ahead and type in, let's say two, and then it created a new line for me. That's what it does by default. And I'm going to press two, and then I get a four. So even though this is a very primitive program, you just went ahead and basically created a simple calculator that the user supplies two numbers, and you add those two numbers for them, and then you return a result. So of course you can use very big numbers. So let's just come up with some random numbers here, and you get the result as well. Pretty powerful for just a few lines of code. So cout allows us to write characters out, cin allows us to get characters in from the console. All right, and I want to talk about two more objects available here in iostream. One is cerr, and that allows you to go ahead and print out an error to the console. Now it will look much like cout, but the nice thing about this is not only is it intended for displaying your errors that occur in the program, but it can be redirected to a specific file that contains these errors, and that can give you a clue as to what happened when something went wrong in your program. So with cerr, we use it much like cout, actually exactly the same, and we can just type something out to cerr. So an error occurred, and then I'll just put a new line character at the end. And then I'll just talk about clog as well, which allows us to make log statements and is also redirected with cerr. So they'll actually show up in the same place depending on where you set it to show up. So here I'll just put a new log statement and then a new line character. And that should be good enough to test things out, so you get a feeling of what everything does. All right, back in the console, I'm just going to go ahead and recompile and rerun the program. Still asking us to supply the two numbers. So I'll just put two random numbers. And then we see an error occurred and a new log statement. But these two actually came from separate objects than the cout up here. So why is this necessary or nice? Well, you can actually redirect these statements here in bash by doing two and then a greater than symbol and just saying some file name. So I'm going to call it errorlog.txt. And now if I run my program, let's go ahead and supply two more numbers and look at that. So we have the two numbers being added together, but we don't have the error occurred and a new log statement anymore. Instead, they were redirected to the error log. So let's check that out. And now we can see an error occurred in a new log statement in here, which is the errorlog.txt file that we created. So very good. It's pretty simple there. And if you went ahead and made it this far, please hit that like button for me. It really does help me out. Let's get back to our program and just go through things once more. So we have four objects here available in iostream. There's actually more, but these are the main ones we want to talk about today. Cout, cin, cerr, and clog. You can write to the user in the console with cout. You can read values in with cin. Make sure that you use the proper less than or greater than symbols. And then we have cerr, which just records an error either to a log or to the console, and clog, which records a logged statement to the same place as cerr or to the console as well. Well, that's really it. Now you know how to interact with the user through the console. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please make sure to post them in the comments section below. Also, make sure to subscribe for future videos and make sure to like the video. Catch me in a great community on Discord, and I'll catch you in another video. Thanks for watching.